So I peruse in my pursuit of all things anthropological. I also want to see what people are doing online because that's an important, it's the most important method of passing information from one area to another. Communication is happening online in real time. That is unprecedented, and that's important. And it's why I spend so much time on the internet. It's why I spend so much time face social networking, not just Facebook and Reddit, YouTube, Twitter, whatever it is, Google, just the internet in general is where it's at. All over websites of news and social significance and societies and all these different things, looking at their pages, looking at their journals, seeing what they have, reading articles from them, talking to people, looking at people, having conversations, getting into, and putting myself out there. And so throughout this process, this anthropological saturation that I have, it's an imbalance. It's an addiction. I can't not engage in it. It's been that way since I was born. As a part of this, the other day I was exposed to a little thing by Carl Sagan, and I kind of like Carl Sagan because he's kind of like the spiritual guru of the scientismist crowd. A lot of atheists out there are, they have trouble reconciling their absolute distrust of anything rational, animistic, and they're very positivist materialists. That's another point about Mormonisms and Catholics. They're positivist materialists who are Christian, and those don't add up. They're not rational animists. They're positivist materialists. Mormons kind of are. Anyways, this is completely off topic. Carl Sagan says religion doesn't change, and it's not completely off topic. But this is Carl Sagan. The thing was by Carl Sagan. I'll try to show it to you. Basically, he says religions don't evolve. Religions don't change. There's no Religions cannot be petitioned or sequestered for redress of grievances. There's never any shift in the religious sphere. And for such an enlightened and well thought of guy who supposedly, for a lot of, if you're an atheist and you're a scientismist, Carl Sagan's like your prophet sometimes. He's one of them. At any rate, the thing about Carl Sagan is that he has no authentic authority. He has no aesthetic understanding of religion at all. And for him to make this claim is absolutely outrageous. For anybody to believe it enough to post it is even more outrageous. But that's the way the world is. It's all good, I understand. The idea that religion doesn't change, I run into it a lot. People always say, hey man, religion doesn't change. Religion never changes. Religion stays the same. Religion's been the same forever. It may be true that religion changes slowly, and I would say actually is the truth is that religion was perfected so long ago that it has to be lost to be perfected again. And that the process of perfecting it is actually what matters the most. Not, obviously that's what we're doing here. At the institution, none at all. Thank you for watching. We are trying to perfect religion. We're trying to distill out the good points and eliminate the bad points and see things in terms of salient functional components of structural, importance, so that we understand not only the horizontal playing field of our interpretation of the universe and ourselves and each other and etc., but that we also have something to keep us connected and give us a sense of community and draw something between us, because we already have those things. For the non-organizationalists who are like, I just want to be alone for my whole life, I don't join groups. You do join groups. You absolutely do join groups. You have to join groups. Everything in this world is a group. Another point for anybody who's in, if you want to be an atheist, positivist, materialist, scientismist, then you have to understand that Darwinian evolutionary theory drives everything. And so I fucking just forgot what I was saying. it drives religion just the same as it does anything else. Damn, this is a really good point. But the point is religion changes. The point is religion absolutely does change. The guys who have changed religion the most are all reformers of it that have split it off and taken it in a new way. And the point is that there's always a consistent thread between it all that matters. So whether you lose, you know, your way or not, man, that thought is right on the outside of my head, man. Anyways, that's it. That Carl Sagan's wrong. Religions change. If you think you know anything about religion and you get your information from religion, from Carl Sagan or Sam Harris or Dick Dawkins, or Bitch Defer Hitchens, I don't even remember, Christopher Bitchens, what's his name? Mittens? Fuck those guys, man. They don't know anything about anything. They're not authorities on religion. They don't study religion. Atheists, getting information from atheists on religion, this is a good point, actually. Atheists are often touted as being people who have, you know, and I don't even know what atheists mean, because a lot of Buddhists are atheists, too. But anti-religion people, in general, they pride themselves on being knowledgeable about subjects and having done homework and using logic and rational conclusions based on the evidence. And then when it comes to religion, they completely just lose their minds. They don't study it, and they don't know anything about it, and they make wild, crazy claims about it, and they have no authority on it. They have no authority. They're not anthropologists who study religion. They're demagogues, they're pundits, they're faces. And that goes really almost for Carl Sagan. I wouldn't argue astrophysics with Neil deGrasse Tyson. You know what I'm saying? I don't do astrophysics, I do religion. If Neil deGrasse Tyson thinks he can argue religion with me, you better step up to the plate, homeboy. You know what I'm saying? But you can't, because I study this shit. I study the shit out of this shit. And Carl Sagan thinks religion doesn't evolve. Where did all these forms come from? I could draw you a phylogeny of religion right now out of my head. Okay? And, like, I can show you how religion breaks from its primary functionary tree. I can show you how it fits in with the real world, all of that, in ways that are classical and well known. And that, if you haven't studied enough to understand it, it's like I said, don't put conservative Christianity up and, you know, take conservative Christianity and fundamentalist Islam and plaster those two things up as the poster child of all religious experience on planet Earth, and then say, yeah, look, all that. Because that's not right, and it's baffling, mind-boggling. I can't believe you guys listen to these people.